Queen, actually. I'm not Bella, if you can tell. We're slightly different. Welcome back, Nick. Thanks, from man. Your holiday.
Yeah.
How was it while you ditched us, while all of this crisis was happening?
It's really rude.
1.5 minutes.
Sorry.
How was your holiday, though?
Came into my body.
How was your holiday?
My holiday was fantastic.
Where'd you go?
I'd already booked it. Because we were having a little baby moon. We've got a baby on the way. I want to get a little break before the baby comes. And my birthday was last week.
Okay.
I'm 26.
Happy birthday. 26.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah.
Are you with a retirement fund?
That's rude.
Are you with one of these?
I.
How's it looking now since the market has...
I prefer not to know.
Okay.
I prefer not to know.
All right.
My holiday, was good. It was
happy
wonderful.
Birthday.
We went to a beautiful place called Port Stevens. Anyone been to Port Stevens? Let us know in the chat. Yeah. Yeah. It's a wonderful place. Water everywhere.
Water everywhere?
In a good way. Okay. We just stayed in this hotel by the pool.
Nice.
And I just drank lots of coffee and lay in the sun, got a little burnt.
Nice.
I kind of loved that though.
Drank a lot of coffee, but while lying down.
Yep.
And relaxing.
Yeah, a lot of relaxing. Now, what do you mean? Gosh, coffee.
Weird, man.
Coffee.
Weird. Coffee and relaxing.
But it was good. We went to a seafood restaurant.
Oh, yeah.
One night. That was my birthday, actually.
We got a bunch of really good seafood,
and they gave us this enormous platter, and then all these utensils to, like, crack the seafood open, and we just had no idea what we were doing.
Yeah.
Do you know how it works? They got, like, these things so you can, like, crack the crabs open and crack the lobster open,
and then
weird, like, utensils to, like, scoop the
stuff
out.
You crack the legs and the shells, and then you're...
The waiter came up to me. So, how are you and Em doing?
We're doing well. We've been isolating. We've been chilling. We've been praying a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Doing a lot of praying. Just as a... I don't know. As a reaction to each day, because each day has been really, you know, you read the headlines and it's like 100 and something cases, and it's like, that's a lot of cases, that's really heavy, let's pray. It's not even this is the time that I pray every day and read and have my quiet time, even though it's a good thing, but it's just like at the end of the day, it's almost like we don't need to know how to digest what's happened, so we just go, let's just go to God.
It's really cool, man.
With this. But yeah.
I kind of love just how everything's been simplified. It's been, like, scary, and there's been, like, moments where you're like, I can't go to school anymore. Some of you are like, that's the best thing ever. Others of you are like, I love school, but you know what I mean? Like, everything's just been chucked out the window.
Yeah.
And suddenly, you've just got space.
Yeah.
And so for us, I think we've just found that having that space to just rethink what's important. For me, that's been just like getting back to my mornings of just spending time with the Lord, reading the Bible, drinking
slowing
coffee.
Down.
Coffee, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's been really good.
It was nice, man.
Yeah.
It was good.
Yeah, though it has been a hard week for us, Becca and I.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so we were on Tuesday, had this big sort of like medical scare where Beck was really unwell. And for a while there, we thought we'd lost our baby. My wife's pregnant. We had a moment where we just thought, you know, this could be it. I was running down the streets of Kirribilli, just sprinting to try and get to the car to try and work out how to get to Becca so that I could take her to the hospital. And then Becca picks me up and she's just like crying. And we get into this car and we drive all the way over to Royal North Shore Hospital. We walk up to like the midwife station and the midwife goes, hello, I talked to you on the phone. And it was just this like moment of like, calm down, everything's gonna be all
you
right.
You guys were like,
freaking out. I was trying to pray. I was like, God, please. I didn't know what to say.
Yeah.
But we just chilled.
Okay.
Had some tests done. Heard Bubba's heartbeat.
Okay. So Becca's fine.
Becca's fine.
Baby's fine.
Baby's fine.
Not delivered. Yeah.
No.
Still there.
I'm joking that she's going to come tomorrow.
Okay, great.
Hasn't come yet.
Okay. Baby's
cool.
Still inside.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
But beating heart.
Beating heart.
Great.
And God is good.
Wow.
God is so good.
That's awesome.
So, you know, Corona's a thing, but life goes on, and
goes
God's
on.
Good.
Night goes on.
Night goes on.
We still here.
We still here.
Oh, we've got some changes, though.
We did have some changes.
We've got some slight tweaks.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
The number one thing that you need to know about is Zoom.
Zoom. Everyone
Zoom.
Say
Zoom.
Zoom.
Zoom. Zoom. Zoom. Zoom. Zoom. Zoom. Zoom. Zoom. Zoom is a program on your computer, your iPad, your laptop, your... What else do you use?
Your pager.
Your phone.
Your phone.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, your radio.
Your enormous smart TV, maybe.
Kindle?
No.
It's not a Kindle. No, it's not.
Zoom's a program where you can video chat with other people, and we are creating spaces twice a week, for you to connect with each other.
Connect.
To do life together.
Life.
To do community together.
Community.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we're going to have two slots during the week to do
that. Two slots.
One is
tonight.
Right after Ignite.
Tonight.
You're going to connect into Zoom.
Connect
into. And we're going to shoot you off into little groups.
Shoot.
Your normal discussion groups. Junior boys.
Junior.
Junior girls. Senior boys.
Boys.
Senior girls. And you're going to have a chance to just chat about talk like you normally would.
Chat.
And it's going to be fantastic.
So good.
Other than that, though, you can do it also on a Monday afternoon.
Monday.
Monday afternoon at 4:30. The idea is you get your afternoon tea. Mm-hmm. You spend some time just together, mm-hmm. chatting about life, checking in, seeing how things are going in the world of Corona and the world of non-Corona.
Get your afternoon tea. You have some afternoon tea.
I do. Donated by the senior boys.
Thanks, guys. You're not here to eat it. So...
I'm going to save this. I'm going to save this for Monday afternoon to eat it in front of the senior
Monday
boys.
Monday afternoon.
Come to
Ignite
find
Zoom.
Out.
Ignite Zoom.
It's Ignite Zoom. You'll find out more info to come. Look down at the link here, or here, or here, or here to connect now.
Click the link. Don't click the link now. It'll actually pause the video.
The next thing is there's a couple resources that we want to give you and help you. A lot of time.
This is the first resource.
We got a lot of time, really.
Yeah.
You need that.
Yes.
First, lather up.
Lather up.
Lather up.
Oh, that was a lot.
Oh, gosh.
Oh. Oh! It's burning my face!
Is it actually?
No, it isn't.
Oh, good.
I do this every day.
You lather up.
Protect yourself.
Then you pick up your copy of The Reason for God by Tim Keller.
Gosh.
This is a fantastic book. If you're sitting here being like, I got all this time, I want to dig into my faith, this is a book that is going to help you understand how Christianity is a intellectually rigorous, evidence-based worldview in which Jesus is a person to be known, but Christianity is a faith to be understood. If you're interested in one of these bad boys, just chuck in the chat right now. I'm interested, and I'm going to make sure you get a copy. I'll drop it around to you if I have to.
Type okay? Interested if you're interested.
I am interested.
Interested. I am interested.
Yeah. So that's a resource. Second thing that you need to know is that the songs that we sing at Ignite are things that are great for us when we're all together, but also for you to just enjoy by yourself. So we put together a playlist.
Spotify playlist.
Spotify playlist.
Woohoo! The playlist is a compilation of some good mad tunes that are... that I personally, Leon as well, Leon Chen, the music intern.
Oh, Leon.
Curtis as well.
Oh, Curtis.
And yourself.
And Nick Wood.
And Nick Wood.
And Julian Yin.
And Julian Yin.
And Emmy.
And Emmy.
And Joel Miley.
And Joel Miley.
You know how many people?
We've just listened to these songs over the past few years, and they've just brought a lot of comfort to us. Mm. And we hope that in this time they bring a lot of comfort to you. But also, we sing them at Ignite, and we will be seeing them on Ignite TV, mm-hmm. and as long as we're a youth group. So, please listen in. Here's the link, just here.
And then.
And here.
Or here.
Don't touch
your phone. Last thing is, we want to put together some WhatsApp groups so that the junior boys, the junior girls, the senior boys, and the senior girls can just keep chatting throughout the week. You've got a place to post your memes, and you know people are going to enjoy it. You can be like, hey, I'd love you to pray for my family right now because we're going through this thing, or hey, this awesome thing happened in my week. Can I tell you about it?
Can I tell you about it?
They're a great opportunity in the midst of social isolation, social distancing, to stay socially connected. That was pretty good, right?
Yes.
That was pretty smooth?
Yeah, that was pretty smooth.
Yeah, great.
Yeah.
That's all for me.
Yeah.
I actually would love to pray before we get to sing some songs together.
Let's pray.
Online. And before we hear the word of God preach, I'd love to pray. Let's pray together.
Let's pray.
Father, we just love you and thank you that you are the king of this entire world. And we thank you, God, that you are always there. We pray right now as we dial in from our homes, as we get to just listen to this music that directs us to you, as we hear from your word open to us and spoken to us in a bold and powerful way. We just want to pray, God, that you would speak to us, that you would change us, that you would encourage us, that you would hold us together in a time of difficulty, that you would give us joy. We trust you, Lord, and we love you. We thank you for everything that you are to us in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Dance break!
Dance break!
Dance break!
It's now time for a
dance break!
Dance break!
What they say, that girls just want to have fun.
Yeah. Did you enjoy the dance break?
I had a great time. Did you enjoy Paul Dale and Rector's Warden Ian Campbell in that dance break?
Well, I sure did. That's a dance break for the ages. But now, wow, now we're going to have I'm Stuck at Home with Leon. But not I'm Stuck at Home with Leon, it's just I'm Stuck at Home and now Leon's here.
Leon's present.
Leon!
Hey!
Alright, hold on. Let's start this thing right. Get in there. Oh, wow. This man is a safe man.
I am safe.
You're glistening.
Thank you.
Leon, it is a season where everyone is stuck at home. Everyone. Have you been stuck at home?
I'm stuck at home, man.
Yeah.
I'm alone.
This looks like your home. Your jumper is the exact same color as this wall.
This is my home.
This is Leon's home.
I am Ignite.
Ignite TV is Leon.
That's it.
So Leon, what we want to know, what Ignite TV wants to know is, what are you doing with your time when you are stuck at home? And what should these guys be doing when they're stuck at home?
You know what you should be doing? I love this thing called mukbangs.
Mukbangs?
So that's where you watch people on YouTube.
Is this one of them
eat.
Youth things?
Oh yeah, big time. I love it.
You watch people on YouTube eat?
Yeah, they eat. I love this guy called Ben Dean. Love this guy called Beard Eats Food or something like that. I love Strictly Dumplings. They're all good. So good. Love them.
So what's so good about it?
I don't know. You get cravings. You can't eat them because Corona's taking all your food away. Corona's taking KFC away. So what do? You just watch people eat KFC. That makes you feel good.
But I think I would just get really hungry and then go to my cupboard and then just be two minute noodles or something.
Yeah, sometimes.
Okay, well, I think some of these guys would be into that. Could you tell me, what is the most interesting thing you've seen someone eat on? What's it called?
Mukbang. Most interesting thing. I've seen someone eat the rude parts of a donkey before.
Oh my gosh.
Yes. Yeah. I don't know if I can say that sort of stuff, but that's a weird thing I've seen.
Well, it happened and you saw it, so I guess you can say it.
Yeah.
This sounds like a wonderful place to spend your time.
Yeah.
I'm very thankful that you shared
highly
that
recommend.
With you. And yeah. I think that's the perfect tone in which for us to go and to begin singing songs to our Lord Jesus and to worship Him. So that's what we're going to do right now. We're going to transition to our band who's going to lead us in worship.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
Ignite, Tom here. I'm going to be bringing us the talk tonight. We're back in the Gospel of Mark. This might be our last one for the rest of the year. So this hopefully will tie up some of the things we've seen, as well as give us a chance to think realistically about life with this virus. So come with me to Mark 4, 35 to 41. I hope you have a Bible somewhere that you can reach. If you don't, ask us to send you a paper Bible just like this one. We'll get it to you right away. So Mark chapter 4, 35 to 41. And it's a story you probably know well. And normally, I would say that there's a danger. There's a danger when we're reading stories that we're really familiar with. Because we check them and think, yep, nothing's changed. And kind of tune out. But I don't think that's going to be our trouble tonight. Because something has changed. Our world has changed. Our culture has changed. Daily routines have drastically changed. And when that kind of change happens, familiar passages like this one, they become fresh again. So that's my prayer for us tonight, that in a chaotic time, we would recognize God's voice and see that it's loud, clear, and full of love. So let's get started. Come with me to verse 35, and I'll read for us. That day, when evening came, he said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along, just as he was, in the boat. There were also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat, so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. Let's stop there. So, last weekend, I was with a friend of mine. He's a doctor now. We went for a surf, and afterwards, we had pies at my place. And we started talking about life with this coronavirus. My friend knows what he's talking about. And it was really interesting to me to hear him speak calmly, but in a way that was deadly serious. He spoke about how hospitals were preparing for war, a war that's about to break out in the heart of Sydney. Hospitals are gearing up, hoping that they have enough stuff for the things that are about to test them. And my friend knew that it was going to be hospital workers like him that were going to be the most exposed and vulnerable. That meant that some of the people he works with every day have a good chance of getting sick and dying. And that's what we spoke about with pies after a surf. But it's not just one friend. I've heard a lot of stories like this, and maybe you have too. And here's the thing, when the people who really know what's going on are deadly serious, the rest of us just need to shut up and listen. But that's exactly what the disciples were like in this story. You see, they were fishermen. They probably were in their boats just about every day and knew what a storm was like. So when this one hit, they knew how bad it could get. And they also knew what they could manage and what they couldn't. At some point, it just becomes too much. They reach their limit and they reach out to Jesus. Where is he? He's asleep on a cushion. So, Ignite, there are three questions I have for us tonight. Three questions that you need an answer for in this time of coronavirus. And here's our first one. It's in the rest of verse 38. The question is, Jesus, don't you care? Read with me. The disciples woke him and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" Maybe this is a question you feel right now. Jesus, don't you care that the virus continues to spread? Don't you care that our hospitals are going to be overwhelmed? Don't you care that people are losing their jobs and their life savings? Don't you care that we can't have normal lives anymore, that I can't see my friend and go to the movies or the beach? Don't you care that I can't go to their birthday parties or my siblings' weddings or maybe even a funeral? Don't you care that we are so afraid? Because, Jesus, I've been following you this far, but right now, it feels like I'm alone. Now, if you are asking yourselves those questions, and I know those questions go through my mind as well, I want to tell you that's okay. You can be honest with God. You can trust him with your fears. In fact, as a church, we're moving into reading the Psalms. Maybe you've already started doing that. And they are filled with examples of godly people who share their fear and open up to God with all of their heart. But I also want to say they teach us to do it in a way that respects God and helps us to grow in our faith, not to ruin our faith. We're going to see a really good example of how a psalm does this later tonight in a song that we're going to listen to that's based on Psalm 42. And I want you to do something for me. As that song plays, I want you to listen to it very carefully. I want you to listen for the words and the points at which it overlaps with this story of the storm. I want you to listen to it, and once you've done that, I want you to blow up our chat with the things that it's teaching you and how you can trust God in a storm like this one. And if that's too personal, you don't want to share that, that's fine. Why don't you just share your favorite lyric? And if that's too much for you, then go ahead, share a meme. Just know that I'll judge you. But for now, let's return to the story and see how Jesus responds to the fear of his disciples. Read with me at verse 39. Jesus got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. So you see, with just a few words, Jesus stops the storm. You do know, don't you, that with just a word, Jesus could stop the coronavirus. That's the kind of authority Jesus has. But he hasn't yet, and he may not stop the virus anytime soon. And if the virus is with us for a while, the question we're going to need to be able to answer is, Jesus, don't you care? I want to tell you that to know whether or not you have an answer to that question, you actually need to see what Jesus says next. Let's read verse 40. Jesus said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" This is our second question. Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith? You see, the disciples saw the storm and were very afraid. They thought, that storm is out of control and scary. They should have thought, we have Jesus. We follow him. He's the one who put us in this boat, and he hasn't left us yet. Jesus doesn't want his followers to live in fear. Don't think that he does. But trusting him is about so much more than just asking for a better life, asking that there be no storms or viruses that we have to deal with. No, Jesus wants us to have faith. Jesus wants us to have a faith that will give us confidence in the big storms and the small ones. Because Jesus' problem with the other approach, the one that just says, Jesus, give me a bit of a better life, is that at the end of the day, it leaves him out. It leaves him out. Most of the world right now is thinking the greatest comfort we could ever receive is for this virus to just be taken away. But that's not true. Because we would still be living in a broken world. And all of the regular sadnesses and troubles that we were already suffering with would still be with us. Jesus doesn't just want to take away the big storms. He wants to take away the small ones too. And he knows how to do it. So the comfort that we have from him is so much better. It's so much better. It doesn't come from him taking away the virus. It comes from him giving himself. He doesn't take something away. He gives us something. He gives us himself. He gives us someone that we can follow through thick and thin. Someone that we can trust is leading us to a better place. So Ignite, does Jesus need to take away the coronavirus in order for us to know that he cares? I want to say no. No. But he does need to show us what he's like. He needs to show us what he's like so that we can know that he is trustworthy. And that's our third and final question. Read with me verse 41. The disciples were terrified and asked each other, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him." The third question that we need to answer is, who is this? When Jesus asked the disciples if they still had faith, it kind of sounds like he's surprised, maybe even disappointed, that they didn't have faith yet. Because by this point, here's what the disciples had seen. They had heard Jesus telling them good news that God's kingdom was near. And they had met him. He had called them to follow him. And they knew that they should. And as they followed him, they saw him heal and cast out demons and even forgive sins. They heard him apply the law of God in a way that brought joy to sinful people. And he made the religious leaders of the time look powerless by comparison. Jesus says, "You've seen all that, and that's enough to trust me in this storm." But Ignite, what about us? What have we seen? We have so much more. They only had the first four chapters of Mark. We have the whole book. We have seen every story of his compassion, of his love for people who are hurting. We have seen proof that God has sent Jesus as the special one who is going to save us from death. And not only that, but we have seen the record of an empty tomb proving that he is greater than death itself. He's in control. And Ignite, I want to say, we don't just see that, but each one of us has seen God work in our lives. Maybe this is a great time for you to ask the people who you're not seeing face to face to share a bit about what they have seen God do in their life. So who do you say Jesus is? You need to have an answer to that question to get through this virus. Those are our three questions. Jesus, don't you care? Jesus asks in response, why are you afraid? Do you still have no faith? And the disciples ask by saying, who is this? If you don't know this already, let me put it as clear as I can. Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, the one who's going to save us from death, and he can still be known today. And if you know him, you can trust that he cares. And if you trust him, you don't need to be afraid. This week, when you're praying for the coronavirus, what are you going to pray? Maybe you pray that God is going to stop this virus And if you do, that's a great thing. But I hope you also pray that you are thankful. You are thankful that God has shown himself to you, that you can know what he is like so that you can trust him. He is good and he is powerful. And he is the one who will save people from the shadow of sin and death wherever he goes, whoever his life he touches. So as long as this virus remains, Ignite, you can live without fear. Come back to these verses when you forget. Let me pray. God, thank you that now, when we feel overwhelmed, you are still there. You are just as in control. You are just as caring as you were to the disciples in this story. Thank you for your words of comfort, words that remind us what you are like. Give us faith to keep following you through the storm until we reach the other side. Amen.
One.
I have lost my appetite, and a flood is welling up behind my eyes. So I eat the tears I pray, and if just the words to cut and tear and cry. When they ask me, where's your God? Why are you downcast, oh my soul? Why so disturbed within me? I can the deer pants for the water, so my soul thirsts for you. And when I survey your splendor so faithfully renewed, like a bed of rest for my feet. Satisfied when I'm staring at the ground, it's an inward feedback loop that drags me down. So it's time to lift my the deer pants for the water, so my soul thirsts for you. And when I survey your splendors, you so faithfully renew, like a bed of rest for my fainting flesh. I am sad. My sighs give way to songs that sing about your faithfulness. Let my pain reveal your glory as we only feel your grace. Let my loss show me all I truly have is you. crashed out on me. I'll recall your safety scheme. You're the one who made the waves, and your soul went out to suffer in my place, and to tell me that I'm as a deer pants for the water, so my soul thirsts for you. When I surrender the splendor you so faithfully renew, like a bed of wings for my fainting flesh. I am sad.
Hey guys, if you haven't met me before, my name is Tan, and I'm about to lead us in a prayer moment, but I just want to encourage you guys, if you have any of your own prayers, feel free to click on the live prayer button, and you can talk to one of the Ignite team about what you really want prayer for, and they'll pray with you. Also, don't forget, after this, there'll be a Zoom meeting where you guys can all pray together, and a link will come up in the chat. How about I lead us in prayer now? Father, we are feeling pretty overwhelmed by life at the moment. Things are unknown. We don't even know what tomorrow will bring. But you tell us in your word that you lack nothing, and in you we lack nothing. So Lord, help us to cling to you. Instead of holding on to all the things that we find our security in, will you help us to let go and run to you? You are strong, faithful, trustworthy, and all over good. You never let us down or leave us behind. Lord, this world feels a little bit out of control, but will you bring your peace and light to light our path so that we can see clearly in this darkness? Keep our friends safe and close. Please build relationships where social distancing feels like it's moving us apart. Bring our family together in love and connect us more than you ever have before. We believe that you are still in control, that you will hold the world together. Every breath I breathe, you gave to me, so I would choose to lean on you in every way. Lord, we thank you for all you've already done, and we pray that you be bringing us closer to you every single day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Wow. What a big Ignite TV we've had tonight.
Enormous.
Enormous. Huge, huge. Large. Don't forget to join us after this. But I think that word from Brother Tom, Father Tom, Father Thomas, Brother Tom, was really timely, I think. I just felt it really spoke into how I'm feeling at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely.
How both Emma and I have been feeling after every day. Mm. And perhaps how you're feeling. What do you think about the topic?
Yeah, I thought that challenge to consider who Jesus is so strong all the time, but particularly when we're kind of feeling those doubts about where is God right now. Mm. Actually, that was exactly what we needed to hear. And I think that's really a great place for us to launch into Zoom. I think to go and just to think through that question for ourselves, who do we think Jesus is, and how is that playing out in the way that we're responding to things at the moment? So I should remind you, this link down here, click on it right now, log into Zoom, connect in, and we'll shoot you into your groups. We'll blow you over into your groups, and you'll be able to discuss with your leaders. It's going to be great. So thanks for joining us. It's been an amazing Ignite TV.
Thanks, team.
But we'll keep chatting.
Week two. It's only been week two.
Groups. I know. Outrageous. Anyway. Do you like my hat?
I do like your hat.
Do you, in the chat, let me know if I should wear this hat next
week. Do you like this hat?
See you guys.
See you soon. Chat soon.